After publishing your first Sitefinity web pages, next in the list of the most common tasks that Sitefinity users handle is creating and managing content itself. In this video, you'll learn how to master content, including working with content items of different types, setting up a publishing workflow, and granularly controlling the data structure and presentation of content. With Sitefinity out of the box, you get several predefined content types that are most commonly used in a content management system. These include news, blogs, events, lists, forms, and media libraries. With the user-friendly interface of Sitefinity, it's easy to navigate, browse, and manage even content-heavy libraries. There may be a case when these predefined content types don't cover your specific scenario. With the Module Builder, you can easily build fully functional content types that meet your needs. To learn more about this useful tool, check out our video about custom content types. Before we jump into content creation, let's talk about content workflow. By defining a workflow, you make sure content isn't automatically published to live before passing the required approval process or editorial review by the right people in the organization. You define and manage workflows that are applied throughout the system in the Administration Workflow section of Sitefinity. You can set a number of properties for each workflow, but one of the most important is the number of approval levels your workflow process abides to. 1, 2, or 3. In this video, we'll define a one-step approval process. If you need a more complex process that includes sending the content item for review, then approval, and finally publishing, then you'll need a three-step workflow. Next, you decide who's in each approval step, that is, which users or set of users with specific roles approve or reject the content item. You can also specify who can skip part of the workflow and choose whether to notify the approvers via email that new content is available for approval. In large organizations with more complex processes, workflows can be defined on a content type, language, or website level. You can thus define one workflow for all news in English in Site A, and then define a more complex workflow for pages in all languages in all sites. Now that your workflow is all set, log into the Sitefinity backend with the author user to create your first news item. To do this, simply expand the content menu, click News, and you're good to go. Add your title, description, and summary so that you and your content editors can easily find the item later. On the go, within the same screen, you can also add new or existing categories and tags for this piece of content so that you can keep it all organized and tidy. You see, as a content management system, Sitefinity has done a great job in providing an intuitive, modern, simple, yet functional design to help authors and content editors do their jobs more productively and efficiently. Creating content is just the first step. Making this content discoverable for both people and search engines is the natural next step. Apart from the meta description you just added, Sitefinity provides you with built-in key SEO tools to improve search engine rankings and make your content easy to find. For example, the content URL. It's SEO friendly, mirroring the title of the item itself, so that both people and bots understand what they see when they click on the link. Additionally, you can tweak the Open Graph properties so you can decide how Sitefinity content is displayed as rich objects via the MVC widgets on social networks. After you're done with creating content and setting its properties, you send the content piece for approval to another user, the administrator, who receives an email notification to log in and edit the content. When the approver logs into the back end, they see just one item in the news section waiting for their approval. Once the administrator is finished with the content, they can either publish it, schedule a specific time and date for publishing, or reject the item and send it back to the author with a reason for the rejection. You just published a news item, but usually news requires images to enhance and enrich the content. To associate an image or other media to a specific content type or page, you add the custom field Related Media so that the field is always there in the back end when you create and edit an item of the specific type. You can also add a Related Data custom field to make relations to other content types, or just a simple short text custom field for including the author's name, for example. Creating a custom field is straightforward and simple. While in the News section, go to Settings, and then click Add a Field. Follow the steps and select the type of field, for example, Related Media, and then what type of media you want to relate to this content type, images, videos, or documents. You can choose to make this field required so that all authors need to use it when creating news, pre-populate instructional text, or choose whether to relate single or multiple media items. Click Save and go back to your news item. There you go. The Related Media section is right there when you edit the content item. To relate the media item, you simply upload a new image or choose from one of your libraries. All set! It's time to let your readers enjoy your content. First, however, you need to make the content visible on your pages via content widgets. Once you place a content widget on your page, it automatically displays all published articles from the news module, including the news item you just created. Content widgets are the link between content and its presentation. A page can display any number and types of widgets that you can configure with different settings and properties. Let's try it out by configuring our news widget to only display news created in the last couple of weeks, sorted by date, and displaying only 5 news items at a time. Now, before you publish your page, you can easily preview it and check out the look and feel of the content and the positioning of the widgets on the page. We hope you enjoyed this video about creating your first content item and workflow. Head to the next video to learn more about the capabilities of Progress Sitefinity CMS. Thank you.